Hey, I'm Samuel Hall. I'm at my range in North Carolina in Yankton County. Got a 300-yard range here in a creek bottom. I'm going to shoot you a five-shot spring here in a minute. Got some real bad conditions today. I didn't pick that good today. Wind right now is blowing about 20 miles an hour. Trees blowing behind me. Mirage is pretty bad. So the wind's blowing, throwing some mirage away. Talked to Paul the other day, and he asked me what my strong point was as a shooter, and I'd have to say that my consistency is my strong point. I believe one of the main reasons I'm consistent, got a good setup, got good equipment, trying out a Leonard stock rifle today. It's got a bad action dual port, it's model MB. I've got a Krieger 1-8 twist barrel, it's 29 inches, got a Vice muzzle brake on it, twist on the barrel is 1-8, it's a 237-bore. I'm shooting a standard 6BR with a 268 neck. Got an old loophole Mark IV, it's been boosted to 35 power, thanks to Larry Eisenhower. Back to the consistency thing. I believe that sitting up on the bench, you got to be totally relaxed. Don't be stressing any muscles from your feet all the way up to your trigger finger. What I usually do, a lot of shooters don't have any bags like this, and they'll hold their hand up, try to steady their hand up. I'll put bags up under my arms to rest my elbow, and I rest my hand on another bag. You might not be able to see it right here. And I'll get behind the rifle and get comfortable. Don't get too low where you've got to sit up too high, and don't sit down too low so you got to slump way over. I just changed my setup. I was sitting beside the table, and I've tried to sit behind the table now, like Terry Brady does, and I think I like that a little bit better. But like I said, don't ever stress any muscles, not any from your feet, not even to your trigger finger. Like I said, if you're trying to support your hand up here, if you start getting nervous, you start shaking. Your hand starts shaking, it goes right to the right. So I'm supporting my hand right here on the pad. Wind's blowing pretty bad right now. I'm going to show you a picture of my range right quick and wait for the wind to die down. It's coming and going.
Got some wind flags set up today. I have got the first white target to the right, that is 100 yards, and the yellow target in the distance is 200 yards. I've got big piles of dirt right there. Might not be able to see them real good, but that's for a good target stop. Just between those two targets, the white one and the yellow one, is 300 yards back in the nook back in there. Exactly 300 yards. That's where I do most of my testing. Usually shoot some at 100 yards, try to get something that's looking pretty good, then I will go back to 300. Paul is wanting me to shoot some at 200 to see what kind of groups I can get. So I've set my target up, the yellow target, at 200 yards. But it does not look like it's going to be a great day to shoot small groups at 200 yards.
Now I chose the dual port because I can work the bolt. And as the round is coming out, I've got my rounds right here beside the rifle. I can reach over, throw a round in while I'm working the bolt right here. Makes it real quick. What I do when I'm shooting my string at 600 yards, I've got wind flags set out, and I'll get zeroed in. After the commence fire on your record target, I'll try to keep my eye on the wind flags, especially my close ones. If I see a change, I'll start pulling over for the change as I'm shooting. If conditions are bad, I'll try to shoot about as fast as I can. If the conditions are holding good, I'll take my time, take a little bit more precise aim. And like I said, if the conditions change, I'll adjust while I'm shooting. I won't stop to wait for a condition to come back. I've tried to do that before, and it's so hard to judge at 600 yards. You've got several different winds, different than shooting 100 yards. Most of the time, you just got a dominant wind to contend with. At 600 yards, you might have wind blowing this way and wind blowing this way. But I try to pay most of my attention to the close flags. Like I said, that makes the most difference. I'm shooting at a bullet hole down here, and I've shot earlier, so it's going to take me a little bit slower to shoot because of the mirage trying to pick out that bullet hole. And one thing I do when I shoot, and I see a lot of people make this mistake in my opinion, as I'm firing and the rifle is recoiling back, I try to keep my eye parallel with the scope. I never raise my head up. Most guys will shoot, raise their head up, look over here, have to get back down on the rifle. It takes a lot of time, and might not get back in the same position. It takes you longer to readjust. You got to readjust your body, your head every time. Try to stay right in line with it. Push it back up. Now don't hold my shoulder up against the butt. I'll push it up with my shoulder back off to the butt to where I can just barely feel it. Just barely feel it on my shoulder. We got some real bad conditions right now, so I'm gonna wait just a minute. I'll show you how I work the bolt. I'll fire, put my thumb on top of the bolt right here, pull the bolt up with that finger, bring it back, throw another round in, just like that. Fire. My thumb is pushing down on the stock, keep the stock down in a bag. If I was picking up like this, you can pull the gun up out of the bag. Okay. Make sure my body, I'm good and relaxed. Relaxing all the muscles in my body. I'm good and comfortable right now. I got my handcuffle. My seat position is comfortable. Okay. Okay, we gotta commence fire. Not the greatest group in the world. Got about a half an inch, looks like, through the scope. I wasn't expecting a whole lot more than that with the wind blowing the way it is, switching back and forth out there. But that's the way I shoot. Y'all have a good day.